Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Lenny. So if you've been following my channel for a while, you probably noticed that my avatar has evolved quite a bit, and I've documented every step of that journey on this channel. I've done several tutorials. I started first with like a simple 2D avatar with minimal movement, and for that I did a tutorial about, if you want to know how to create a 2D animated avatar, I'm gonna drop the link, or I'm gonna link that tutorial video in the description box or in this video itself so that you can go check it out. But then I started off with a simple 2D avatar with minimal movement, and then I upgraded it to a more human-like version. And again, I did a tutorial about that. If you want to learn how I did that, I'm gonna leave the link to that tutorial as well on the screen so that you can go check it out. So after I did that, it became a lot more human, because this avatar I used to have sort of was able to not just talk but also make some gestures, work and all that. So that was great. But in today's video, I'm going to be transforming my AI avatar again to a 3D animated cartoon avatar, and I'm probably gonna keep this for a while as well till I decide to change this again, and then I walk you through the process. While doing that, I'll probably also change like my voice and everything, because that's the flexibility AI gives you. You get the ability to make changes whenever you want to. In this video, I'm going to walk you through the entire process of creating your own 3D animated AI avatar by step using AI tools. Let's get into it. So the first thing is you need to first have an image. So as you know, I already do have an image of my previous avatar, so I'm going to be using that same image to generate the cartoon. And to do that, I'm using a tool called FlexClip. When you come into FlexClip, all you have to click on is AI, and when you click on AI, it will take you to the AI image to image, and in here you can just upload your image. So I'm just going to upload my image for my old Lenny AI avatar. Like I'm saying, like I really like this because it gives you like a flexibility to do whatever you want. Okay, so I've uploaded my image. Once you upload your image, it brings you to the screen where you could basically select the type of transformation you want. So I'm going for the 3D. I'm just gonna select 3D, and then I'm gonna choose this one. So they have a number of like different 3D cartoon characters you can go for. So I'm just gonna go with this one, then I'm gonna click on generate. Yes, as you can see, because it has been generated for us, it really looks good. So now that this has been generated, I'm just going to click on download. And then the next step is, once this is generated, the next step is to generate the video. And then again, I'm still going to be using FlexClip. So I'm going to go into the AI video generator tool in FlexClip, and I'm using the exact same image here. And I'm going to upload the image. I know I already do have one here. I'm just going to upload the image, and then really just upload the image that I just got off the internet. So now that the image has been uploaded, I'm just gonna put in a prompt in here, and I'm just gonna say she's talking into the camera, and I'm gonna go for the professional one, and for duration I'm gonna choose 10 seconds, and then I'm gonna click on generate. Okay, so our video has been generated. As you can see, this is a video that was generated. It looks really clean. There isn't so much of a glitch. What I would recommend is when you sort of create a video and you see a lot of glitches, then what you have to do is basically edit them out. You can do that in CapCut. So you basically are depending on how long you want your video to be. You can basically generate multiple variations of this so that you piece them together. I'm going to download this now onto my computer. So now that you've downloaded this onto your computer, the next step is sort of like creating the voice. And in terms of the voice, you could use your own voice, but you know that I like to sort of make some changes to my voice as well. I'm going to come into 11 Labs here, and then I'm just going to click on voice changer, and I'm going to upload my voice, the voice I already do have in here. Okay, so I'm just going to use Alice just for the purposes of this tutorial. I'm just going to select Alice, and in terms of style exaggeration, I don't want to do anything, any of that, just because if you do style exaggeration, it just makes it sound funny. So once you have this done, all you have to do is click on generate speech. Yeah, so the voice has been generated for us. The next step is to just click on download and download the voice. So now that the voice has been created, our video is ready. The next step for us is to do the lip sync, okay? And like I said, if you had done multiple syncs or created multiple videos so that you could join them, then this is what it would look like. You would have multiple clips in here, and then you just have to go into CapCut and sort of like piece them together, cut out any glitches that show up, and then you just like export them so that you have like a clean own video. So I'm just gonna export this and say new, and then I'll just like export them. This is if you had multiple things. From what I did, I didn't have like multiple scenes. I just did one scene. I just want to give you an idea of how it would look like if you had like multiple videos created for your avatar. So I'm just going to export this just so you know, and then I'm going to now upload this into the lip sync model, because once you have your video ready, all you need is just to do the lip sync. And for the lip sync, I'm going to be using a different tool today. In my previous tutorials for lip sync, I've used tools like sync.so. For this tutorial, I'm going to be using like a different lip sync tool, and the tool is called boba.video. I'm going to leave the link to all these in the description box, and so that you can go check it out. When you come in here, all you have to do is like, you really have to just upload your video. So I'm just going to upload a video I just created. I'm going to come in here and I'm just going to drag this in here to the video, and then I'm also going to upload the audio as well. So for the audio, I'm going for this one as well, the one that we just created on 11 labs, and we have both of them ready now to go. So all we have to do at this point is just click enter. And the good thing about Boba is that it gives you 250 free credits, so you could basically try it out. And I noticed this, that it's just like 50 credits, so it's not based on the time or the length of the video. With other tools, I think so, it sort of like calculates the based on like the duration of the audio, but this one did not really do that. It just said 50 credits, which I think is cool. And so 250 credits would really take you a long way. And then I'm gonna click on enter in here, and once you click on enter, you'd see that it's gonna start generating for you. Okay, so the video lip sync has been generated for us, and I'm gonna play the final out. Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Manny. If you want to go viral with short form content without editing for hours, then in this tutorial, I'll show you how to build an AI crowd agent in M8M, that which Mike Scully creates and publishes miniature style short videos that are highly shareable and perfect for platforms like YouTube Shorts, TikTok, and Instagram Reels. Okay, so that is it for today's tutorial. If you enjoyed this tutorial, as usual, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, leave your comments in the comment section below, share with your friends, share with anyone who is looking to learn how to create their own AI avatar for their YouTube channels or for their social media accounts. And like I mentioned, this might be my AI avatar for the next few months until I decide to like change things up a bit. But yeah, that is it for today's tutorial. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.